Hey guys, round three, game one. I'm on the draw. I kept my hand. I was pretty happy with it. Ah, and wasn't paying attention. That is questionable at best. So it looks like these two guys are going to bounce off each other all day. Frig, very angry that that happened. My cathedral here should have been turn one play. So anyways, this guy is playing blue-black. He's got double murder, invaders, fairy invaders times two, or fairy invaders, double murder, and a mark of the vampire. So it's he's got a thing. He's also got like that unblockable dude. So he took all my black is basically what happened here. So I guess Nighthawk comes down next. Gotta keep the beats going. Keep the beats. Keep the beats on. And then next turn, Cathedral of War. So I made a mistake. He murdered my guy. What a dick. Alright. Not a problem. He's got double murder. It's a thing. Cathedral of Audric, Crusader of Audric. Double Crusader of Audric's also a thing, so pretty happy about that. I like how right now we can't even engage. Our knights just are afraid of each other. Can't block, can't. Yeah. Giant scorpion. I think I just attack here. And I think I take the Vampire Nighthawk, right? Yeah. Just so I can get that lifelink and make the race a little bit better for me. Awesome. That's awesome. So now I say, take out this extra land that I stupidly put in, which actually hasn't hurt me so much playing 18 lands in a 41 card deck. But I can see how that could be a problem. Yeah. This is a deck. This is a thing. That was a very good first round, I have to admit. I guess he just did not have an answer to Vampire Nighthawk. And that makes me very happy. Man, that's crazy. It's just waiting here. He's probably doing some crazy fine-tuning of his deck with sideboard choices. I don't really know what to do there. I have to admit, double Knight of Glory is good against him. Double Vampire Nighthawk's good. Audric is good. You know what? I would be happy with, like, a murder or two. I would rather have a murder than a Crippling Blight, for example. But, you know, Rise from the Grave has actually been relatively good, and I always bring back the Nighthawk. It's just power. Such a powerful card, Nighthawk. Audric's crazy. Alright, let's go. Let's get this going. I'm excited. Okay, we're back. I am not mulliganing this hand. This hand's pretty good. He's got Knight of Glory. He's got his unblockable one drop. If he puts Mark of the Vampire in it, I'll be one sad panda. I see where this is going. Kraken hatchling, eh? Okay. Alright. That's a thing, I guess. Here's a hilarious thing for removal. Putting Mark of the Vampire on this guy would be very much removal, especially after he puts his own Mark of the Vampire. Yeah. Okay, so my turn. Ah. Knight of Glory! You attack. Oh, you attack so bad. So I got no ring. It's pretty nice. Kraken Hatchling, not as excited about dealing with, to be fair. Not excited at all. Harbor Bandits, also not excited about dealing with him. Might want to... O-ring the... Harbor Bandits. Mark of the Vampire is markedly less good with... with his two murders in his deck. So really, it's like the greatest way to remove this, though. It is. It's actually pretty awesome way to remove a tormented soul. And I might just use his removal. I kind of want him to drop a Mark of the Vampire on it, though. Oh my god, how amazing that would be. How amazing that would be. So I think I'll just drop a Griffin Protector right now. Because the other option is I drop a Mark of the Vampire on my Griffin Protector, which I'm not super excited about doing, because, again, if he murders it, it's a two-for-one that you really can't do much about. So my Griffin is going to get in there pretty well, I think. One and two. So six damage is some real damage here. Like I said, I do have removal for his Tormented Soul. He's got Fairy Invaders, I see. Okay, okay. So definitely, well, let's see what he's going to do. Is he going to attack? He's attacking the Fairy Invaders. Okay. So now the question is, do I... So it's four, deal six, gain some life back, maybe? Risky, really risky, to put the mark on him if I do gain some life back. I think I gotta do it. Sort of against the ropes right now. Yeah, this is a thing I gotta do. Definitely gotta do it. What's going on here? Hello? Okay, he's leaving. Okay, he left. Well, anyways, that was a weird few rounds, but thanks for watching, guys. I think I had a pretty strong deck regardless of what happened. I mean, the second round I got mana screwed like crazy, which is very annoying. But Audric's good, double Nighthawk is good, Double Knight of Glory is good. Anyways, Mark of the Vampire is obviously good. See you guys on the other side. Bye.